Hello and welcome to another virtual Messy Church. It is fantastic to see you and we are so, so glad that you have joined us again this morning. Now today we have all of our Messy Church favourites ready for you. We're going to do some singing, there's going to be a story, we've got a craft for you and even some more yummy food for you to make. Now I'm going to start with something a little bit different this time and I'm going to hand over to my friend Claire, who's got a few clues to give you about today's story. So listen carefully, have a look and see if you can guess what it might be.
Hello, it's Claire here. I've just been having a go at doing some stone painting because I think it's really fun. I've been enjoying finding them all over the woods and at the parks and places over the last few weeks where people have left them. And I thought I'd do a stone painting to show you the story that I'm going to tell today. But just to give you a hint of what it is. Can you see my rather wonderful sunshine? I'm quite proud of that one. What's that? That looks like gentle waves to me. A boat. Look at that. Now, what's going to happen in my story at one point is that the weather's going to change. A thunderstorm. The waves become really choppy and the poor boat has to cope with a terrible storm. Do you think you know what the story is going to be? You have to wait and see.
Have you worked out what the story is? I've got a few ideas, but I can't wait for a little bit later on when Claire tells us the story. For now, we are going to sing a song and something very, very exciting at this month's Messy Church. We don't just have Stu, who's going to come and do a song a little bit later. We have a full band with us today and a couple of our friends from church even doing the actions for you as well. This song is called Be Happy and we hope that as you sing it, you can have lots of fun jumping around and doing the actions together. Enjoy.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm gonna jump up and down, gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, gonna send my praise to heaven. I'm gonna jump up and down, I'm gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, I'm gonna send my praise to heaven. I will run this race and I will never stop. I'll follow Jesus till the day I drop. Such a lot when you got not a lot. What? Be happy. I'm gonna jump up and down, I'm gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, I'm gonna send my praise to heaven. I'm gonna jump up and down, I'm gonna spin right around, gonna praise your name forever. I'm gonna shout out loud, gonna deafen the crowd, I'm gonna send my praise to heaven. I will run this race and I will never stop. I'll follow Jesus till the day I drop. I can do all things in Christ who strengthens me. When you got such a lot, when you got not a lot, why? Be happy. And I will never stop. I follow Jesus till the day I drop. I can do all things in Christ who strengthens me. When you got such a lot, when you got not a lot, what? Be happy.
Now, I thought I'd have a go at making a boat out of some of the things that I've managed to find around my house. Let's have a look what I managed to find. I've got a milk carton, a pot, an egg carton, and I've just decided to use the lid, and a sponge. And then I've managed to find some straws and some wooden sticks. I've got some paper. And I've got some masking tape and some scissors. So let's see what I can have a go at making. Loved finding different things around my house to use to make boats. And a little bit later, I'm going to go and put them in some water and see which one is the best boat. Now, somebody else who's been thinking a lot about boats is our friend Helen, and she's been coming up with some amazing ideas of how you can make boats using food. I can't wait to see what she's come up with. So let's head over to her kitchen right now.
Hi everyone. Great to see you at Messy Church again. Still Messy Church online, but still some great activities that we're going to do, I hope. I saw some brilliant pictures of some pizzas that you guys made last time. And I hope you tried those biscuits because they're so delicious. I know that you all like eating them. I thought this month we might try and go a little bit healthy, only a little bit. I wonder if you know the story this week yet. The theme of the story is that it's going to involve a boat. So you might be painting boats, you might be looking at pictures of boats, you might be making your own boats. So I thought, what things might you have at home and what could you make into a boat? So I went and looked in my fruit bowl. You probably can't see all the things here, but I've got a satsuma and a banana, some grapes, apple, a cucumber from the fridge. So some pretty normal things that hopefully you might have at home and you can choose the ones that you like the best. I wonder if you can have a go like I did at making some boats. Now I'll make sure we do a photo at some point so you can see these a bit better, but I won't know if you can see that a really straightforward boat is an apple. And actually, I raided the fridge and got a bit of cheese to make my sail. And there's a banana boat here. That one's a bit wobbly. This one, if you're feeling a little bit more adventurous, my cucumber boat with its sort of whizzy sail. And if you've got a bit of time on your hands and you've got the right ingredients, maybe you can try making a jelly boat. This one was quite fun. I'm not going to go through how to make all of them, but you might just want to get the idea of how you could make a fruit boat using the different things that you've got and the different things that you like, because the best thing is that after you've made it, you can eat it. So if you like bananas, then you might want to cut the base of your boat to be a banana. And then it's really easy to get some little cocktail sticks, or you might have kebab sticks. And I threaded on some little satsuma pieces because they were going to be my sails. I suspect that one's going to lie down. If you like apples, then you could put apples and grapes. Again, you can thread some grapes onto your cocktail stick. I also like cheese with my apple. Sometimes that can seem like a strange combination, but I think if you very carefully cut or get somebody else to cut for you, a triangle shape from your cheese, you can make quite a nice cheese and apple boat. So you've got to be quite careful at how you get the stick to go through, because sometimes the cheese breaks. But I think that one has worked. So you can make an apple and a bit of cheese and make that into your boat. That would be quite nice to eat afterwards. If you've got time, and if you can persuade Mum or Dad or whoever does the shopping to go to the supermarket, you might be able to get some jelly. And I made up the jelly, and I've put the jelly into half of an orange. So I made a whole one, because you saw the other ones I've made. But we made the recipe for the jelly that you get on the packet. We made it only half as much liquid. So the jelly inside there is really nice and strong. And when I was getting the jelly to set, I rested it in a little pot so that he could stay upright. And hopefully, when your jelly has set, you could leave it as half a boat. But I think if you want it to look even more like a boat shape, you very carefully need to cut your jelly boat in half. And hopefully, look at that, your boat, your jelly, will stay in the shape. So you could eat it like that, or you could make it into an actual boat. I'll put in one cocktail stick, and I've got blueberries, I've got grapes. You could put anything on top, really, to make it into a bit more of a boat shape, so that you could have a nice healthy snack with your cucumber boat, have a savoury one, or you could have your apple and cheese boat. And then if you wanted something sweet for pudding, you could even try your jelly boat. I hope that you might have a go at doing some different fruit boats, or maybe something else that you can use. If you do come up with some good ideas, then take a photo and you can post them on the Facebook page, send them out, because everyone else might like to see them too. But for the moment, I think I'll eat the apple and cheese boat. Bye.
Wow! Isn't our friend Helen clever? She's always coming up with amazing ideas of food that we can eat and make at Messy Church. And you know, I've had a go at this one. And for my boat, I've used some apple, a tangerine, and some cucumber. It's good. Okay. While I enjoy this, I think it's about time we heard our story. So let's go and visit Clare in her garden.
Jesus had been busy talking to loads of people. Huge crowds had gathered to hear him speak. And at the end of a very busy day, he was really tired. So he decided to go out in a boat with his disciples. And as they went out, the weather was beautiful. The sun was shining in the sky. There were blue skies everywhere, no clouds, and the water was so calm. Now Jesus was very tired, so he sat in the back of the boat and fell asleep. But as time went on, the weather started to change. It was no longer calm waters that surrounded them, but rocky waters. The disciples started to get more and more frightened and worried. Storm clouds came down, there were rumbles of thunder, and before they knew it, they were in a terrible, terrible storm. And all the while, Jesus was asleep. Fear reached all of the disciples now. They were terrified, and they turned to Jesus and they shook him and they said, wake up, master, don't you care that we're going to drown here? Jesus woke up, looked around him, saw the storm, stood up and reached out his hands to the choppy waters and the raging skies. Be still, Jesus said. And amazingly, that's exactly what happened. The waves calmed back down again. The clouds and the thunder disappeared and left the skies blue and the sun shining as before. The disciples were amazed. wasn't that a fantastic story? It's one of my favourite stories. What I didn't say was that at the end of the storm, when it was all calm, hello doggy, when it was all calm and the storm had passed, the disciples said to each other, "Who is that man? Even the wind and the waves obey him." Jesus is amazing. Right, well, somebody's come to say hello to me. Hang on. Hi, Lizzie.
Hello.
Hi, this is my daughter. She's Lizzie. She's 11. She used to come to Messy Church a lot, but she hasn't come for a little while now. She's a bit big, aren't you? It's nice to see you. Anyway, well, thank you so, so much to everybody for listening to us today.
In the storm.
Oh, no, I didn't want that at all. Well, if I'm getting wet, then Helen's going to get wet too. Here it comes, Hel.
Oh, no. Clare, I can't believe you threw water all over me. I'm soaked.
Well, if Claire's getting wet, and if I'm getting wet, Becky, you're getting wet too.
Helen, I can't believe you just did that.
Right, well, I go and get dry. Let's say a prayer.
Can you see the picture of the boat on your screen? This small boat is in the middle of a massive storm. The waves are huge and choppy and frightening, and the clouds are dark and menacing. And right in the middle of the boat are the poor disciples, terrified out of their wits that they're going to die in this storm. Well, we're going through something that's a bit like a storm at the moment, isn't it? While we're in lockdown, things feel frightening and scary. We can't do the things that we usually do. We can't go and see our friends at school. We can't go and see the people that we know and love who are poorly or not feeling very well. And nobody really knows how long it's going to go on for. I wonder what things feel stormy for you. Maybe there's a specific best friend that you are dying to see again. Maybe you're annoyed because you can't go to your weekly swimming lesson and you love it so much. Maybe you're worried because somebody that you know and love is not feeling very well at the moment and you can't be with them. Let's just spend a short moment telling Jesus all about the things that feel stormy to us. Now have a look at the picture again, because can you see that Jesus is there? Jesus is in the boat with his terrified disciples in the middle of the storm. He hadn't left the disciples, and even though they were feeling fearful and worried, they didn't need to be because he was there. What's comforting for us to know is that Jesus can calm these storms that are even within us, and he can replace the storms with his peace. Our problems will still be there, but we can trust God and give our problems to him. With him helping us, we will find peace. Heavenly Father, please be with us in this strange time. Thank you that you've never left us. You've been with us, beside us, through all that we've been going through over these past few weeks. And thank you that you'll be with us in the same way over the coming days and weeks and months ahead. We pray that we will feel your peace in our hearts. Amen.
Well, that's better. I've got changed and I even managed to dry my hair. I can't believe you two. You're so, so naughty. I don't know. I think it's time for another song, and this time we're going to go and visit our friend Stu for a song called My Lighthouse, and it's all about how Jesus is the light in the darkness. There are some actions, so feel free to join in.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, in the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, and I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore. I won't fear what tomorrow brings. With each morning I'll rise and sing. 'Cause my God's love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. You are my lighthouse, shining in the darkness. I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, and I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore, safe to shore. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Far before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Oh, my lighthouse, shining in the darkness. Oh, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, and I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore. Safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore.
What a good song that is. Thank you so, so much for coming along to Messy Church today. We hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. It's been fabulous to see you. Please do send some pictures of all the different things you've been up to. We'd love to see any boats that you've made, whether they're made out of craft material or food. We'd also love to see any videos of you throwing water on people too, because why not? Send them into our Facebook page and let everybody else see them too. Take care, and we can't wait to see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.